When you install a Python library, odds are you use pip to install the library. But how do you set up a project to be pip installable? Well, it's not as complicated as you might think, but there are a few steps. Let's take a look at how this works with an extremely simple Python package that we're going to make into a pip installable library. This package does only two things. When it's first imported, it prints a message to the console. When you run the hi function and you pass a name to it, it prints a greeting to the console with that name. The first important thing we need to make this package pip installable is to have the proper layout for the files. What I'm showing here is a greatly simplified version of a modern Python project layout. Inside the base directory for the project, there's a subdirectory named src for source, and inside that is our actual Python package. That package consists here of nothing more than a single init.py file, but there could be far more code in here if we needed it. The other key element is a file in the root of the project directory, pyproject.toml, and this file holds all the metadata about the project, and it can get quite large and involved, but all you need for starters is this, a section labeled project, and the name and the version of your project. Now let's demonstrate installing this project into a virtual environment. I have one set up on this project with nothing in it but pip. To install my HiThere project from where it lives on my system, I can use pip install and then pass the full path to the project directory, or I can just use a dot to indicate we're in the directory where the project lives. So once it's installed, we can do pip list, and we can see that HiThere version 0.1 is installed. If we launch the interpreter and import HiThere, we get our import message. Run the hi function, and we get our greeting. Now, once we've made this project pip installable, that opens up all kinds of ways that it can be reused. I can install it into other projects' virtual environments from its source directory. I can create a wheel or other archive, and I can provide that to others as a pip installable source. I can post the code on GitHub and have others install it from there. And I can upload my project to the Python Package Index, or PyPI, for all the world to reuse. And I will be exploring all of these scenarios in future videos, since each one of them follows a slightly different path. And for more complex projects, you're going to need to provide much more metadata in pyproject.toml than I've shown here. But as you can see at bottom, making a project pip installable is really not that hard. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.